Hey, this is Dr. Amanda here with Straight Smile Solutions, and today we're going to be talking about hand-wrist x-rays in orthodontics. Why do we need them? How can we use them? Why are they useful? And should we get them? So many things to talk about. Now, I use these all the time. Why? Well, basically, in a nutshell, sometimes you need to know about growth. It doesn't matter if you're an orthodontist, a general dentist, a pediatric dentist, a pediatrician, you need to know about growth. You need to know if your patient is done growing, still growing, about to grow, about to reach peak growth potential. I mean, even sometimes coaches like to know this information. I know they do. So this is really useful information. Hey, heck, I've got kids. They want to know this information. Guess what? I can get out my magic crystal ball and be a Miss Cleo, and I can tell you, are you far away from puberty? Or your growth spurt? Are you and getting there close? Are you about to max out? Or are you done growing? And I can find all this out from a hand-wrist x-ray. Sweet, isn't that awesome? Now for orthodontics, it's particularly important because sometimes we're trying to time a certain type of treatment, whether we're trying to time certain type of treatment to correct a bite problem, or just timing braces in general to like harness the growth, or thinking, are we going to have any more growth? Is this, or should we change a treatment plan that maybe doesn't factor in growth? Or maybe we're thinking about doing orthognathic surgery. So many reasons we need to know this for ortho. And I think sometimes there's a lot of ways that people could find out about growth. Of course, sometimes people just say, oh, the child's 12, they must be growing. Well, not necessarily, because girls can have their peak growth spurt from age 8 to age 14. Boys can have their peak growth spurt from age 10 to age 17. So there's some big windows in there. So the age doesn't necessarily have anything to do with it, chronological age. The dental growth or dental age doesn't have anything to do with it. You could have a girl that only lost 8 teeth and they could be done growing. So sometimes it has nothing to do with one another. And parents don't necessarily get this. Okay, so many things to think about. And if you do this, not only are you going to be more successful in explaining the value of the treatment plan to the patient and the parent, but your timing and your outcomes are going to be better because you're making more educated and wise decisions. So that's why I recommend doing this. Now, how do you do this? You can do this on any ceph plate. If you already have a cephalometric x-ray machine, it's really easy. You might have to play with it a little bit, but it's basically on the same plate. Okay. I'm assuming you can do it on a CBCT. I haven't tried it, but pretty cool stuff. What do you need to know? Well, I'm taking my analysis. This is like a modified analysis because what's out there is so flippin' confusing for most people. And I know how to do the other version, but it's more information than I need. And it gets confusing when I try to teach other people how to do it. So I've made it like way simpler here. So this is my version, Straight Smile Solutions version of a hand wrist analysis. Okay. So copyright 2019. So this is based on the research and the Atlas of Groelich and Pyle 1959. This is just standard stuff. Okay. I just tried to break it down and make it more simple. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're only going to look at 3 points. I need to know some basic anatomy first. Okay. Now in the phalanges or finger bones, okay, when you're growing, you have an epiphysis. Okay. Which is like the end of the bone, and a diaphysis, which is basically in between is the growth plate, okay? So the diaphysis is like the little bone here, and the epiphysis is right here, okay? So these are separate as you're growing, and when you finish growing, they fuse together, okay? So that's what you need to know. You need to know the difference between a diaphysis and epiphysis. You need to localize them, okay? The other bone that I want you to know about is called a sesamoid bone. The sesamoid bone is a little bone and looks like that, and that's exactly where it's going to be. And that presents at a certain time in growth, okay? So it's not in a young child. It's only in a pubertal child. You'll start to get one little dot in your thumb, okay? The last spot, so I said only 3 spots, middle phalange of the middle finger, so middle, just this spot right here, okay? The sesamoid bone and the wrist bone, the radius here. Again, epiphysis and diaphysis. These two, and is there a space in between them? That's it. That's all I want you to know. 3 spots, middle, sesamoid, and radius bone. Okay? 3 things on any x-ray, and then you can use it from there. So there's 6 stages that I break it down into. You've got your pre-puberty, 3 years before peak puberty. That means like for a girl, 3 years before you're going to get your period, 3 years in a boy before their voice is going to change and they're going to stop growing. Okay? Puberty is just starting. Puberty is peaking. Puberty is almost done. and puberty's done. Okay? So those are my six different steps. And this is like super important because if I wanted to time treatment for ortho, I don't necessarily want the pre-puberty time or even the 3 years before peak puberty. I kind of want it like right here for the most part, okay? Or here. But ideally, I'm trying to aim for right in between here for most ortho growth modification things, okay? So like I said, you can't go by the chronological age. So we're going to look at those 3 points, middle, look for the sesamoid bone, and look at the fusion of this bone right here. Easy, all right? So pre-puberty, what are we looking for in pre-puberty? In pre-puberty, your epiphysis and diaphysis are not fused in your middle. Sorry, it's covered up right here, okay? And actually, your diaphysis, your diaphysis is smaller than the epiphysis still, okay? So you can see here, see that? It's smaller than the epiphysis, okay? So there's a little line in between and it's still smaller, okay? That's pre-puberty, but on middle. So right now I can tell you on this, we'll see it in a second, this x-ray is actually right here. So see it? Middle on either finger, diaphysis, epiphysis, not the same size, and they're not fused, okay? So this child is totally prepubertal, not even happening within the next 3 years, okay? So most likely this child is 5, 6, something like that, maybe 7, okay? So we look at the other landmarks that we talked about. Is there a sesamoid bone? Nope. And is this fused? No, okay? 3 spots. So that's great. What else? 3 years before peak puberty, the epiphysis and the diaphysis are equal in size, but not fused, okay? So that's the kind of bing, 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 growth is coming. So that's kind of where I want to start timing stuff, okay? Puberty is like actively starting. That's when the sesamoid bone shows up, that little dot on the thumb. Oh no, we've got to get a move on now. It showed up, you know? Puberty is like peaking. Whoa, bread alert, it's peaking, okay? So when it's peaking, and I probably don't have the best example of this here, but you'll see the epiphysis and the diaphysis kind of starting to fuse together and making like a cap, okay? It looks like a hat. So like the ends are kind of touching, but in the middle, there's still a space. That is like peaking, okay? That's peaking. And puberty's almost done. That's when you already have the sesamoid, but the fingers are fused. Now the middle is fused, okay? But the radius is not fused yet, okay? So see the radius is not fused, there's still a space. So let's see the example of an adult. This is an adult hand. I can work my way backward. Radius is totally fused, right? So then we know this is a completely an adult. Sesamoid bone is right there. Total fusion, right? No capping, no space on middle. That's it. It's that easy. I hope you loved it. I know I did. I'm excited to share it with y'all. And don't forget, you can go to StraightSmileSolutions.com to learn so much more. And if you'd like help with your ortho cases, we're there for you. You can just subscribe to our services. Please don't forget to share the word. All right. Thanks so much. Have a great day.